What if I told you that most Windows 10 users are being blocked from upgrading to Windows 11 by Microsoft's hardware requirements, but there's actually a tool that makes it really easy to bypass Microsoft's restrictions and check your computer's real compatibility? In the next few minutes, I'll show you exactly how to use Flyby11 to upgrade your Windows 10 PC to Windows 11, while giving you the absolute best chance of keeping all of your files, settings, and apps exactly as they are. Now, here's the problem most people run into when they try to upgrade. First, they get blocked by Microsoft's hardware compatibility checker, even though their PC can actually run Windows 11. Second, they download the wrong Windows 11 installation media, which prevents them from keeping all their files, settings, and apps. And third, they end up with repeated failed upgrade attempts and their PC keeps getting rolled back to Windows 10. Now, Flyby11 solves the first problem really easily. The second one I'm going to show you the best chance of solving in this video. And then the third one is a little bit more complicated, but I'll mention your options later on in the video. But before we get started, let me just say that this video is for educational purposes only. I'm not telling you that you must use Flyby11, and I'm also not telling you that you must upgrade to Windows 11. I'm simply providing you with a tutorial on how to do something and also giving you troubleshooting steps along the way. Let's get started. So Flyby11 is available on GitHub, and to download it, you'll need to scroll down till you get to the releases section here and then click on the latest release. Then if you scroll down on the next page, you'll find the Flyby11 zip file. You can click on that to download it. Then just open it in the downloads folder, extract the files. Once it's extracted, just open the folder and then you can run the Flyby11 application. You might get a smart screen prompt. You can just click on more info and then run anyway. And then Flyby11 will be launched with the Windows 11 compatibility check. So you'll see that it checks for CPU pop count and SSE 4.2 instructions. Now I need to be completely clear about something important. There are two different types of requirements for Windows 11. You get Microsoft's artificial requirements like TPM and Secure Boot and so on, which can be bypassed. And then you get the real hardware limitations like these CPU instructions that can't be bypassed. But I've made a detailed video about this already, and you can find that linked in the description below if you want to know more about these differences. But as you can see, the upgrade probability for this computer is very high. If one of these checks failed, then you'll most probably not be able to upgrade to Windows 11 24H2, but you'll still be able to run older versions of Windows 11. So to be crystal clear, Flyby11 bypasses Microsoft's artificial hardware requirements, but it also honestly tells you if your CPU has the actual technical requirements that was introduced in Windows 11 24H2. But we're going to go ahead and start the upgrade process, so you can just click on Start Upgrade Now. And then you'll get to the next screen where we need to provide it with a Windows 11 ISO file that it can use to start the upgrade process. Now here's the crucial part that most people get wrong. Now you can see the developer here says that you can download the latest ISO file from the official Microsoft website or use the FIDO downloader, which is recommended by the developer. But I'm going to show you a specific method using Microsoft's media creation tool that'll give you the absolute best chance of keeping all of your files, settings, and apps during the upgrade process. So on the Windows 11 downloads page here, if you scroll down all the way to the bottom, you can download the Windows 11 ISO file directly, and that is usually what I do. However, in this video, we're going to be using the media creation tool. So click on download now to download the media creation tool. And I'll show you in just a moment why we want to use this tool. Once it's downloaded, just open it, select any prompts if you do get any. And then after a while, the media creation tool should be launched on your computer. Just go ahead and accept the terms. On the next screen, you'll see the select language and edition screen. Now, this is exactly why we're using the media creation tool, because we have the option to use the recommended options for this computer that we're downloading the ISO file from. So this will give us the best chance of keeping our files, settings, and apps when we get to the upgrade process. So leave this exactly as is, then click on next. Then you want to choose the ISO file option, click next. And then you can just save this anywhere on the computer. I'm going to save it on the desktop and then just call it Windows 11. and then just click on save. And now that's going to start the download process of the Windows 11 ISO file. Okay, so once the download completes, we'll feed this ISO file into Flyby11, and then it'll automatically handle the upgrade process for us. So once the media creation tool is finished downloading the ISO file, you can just click on finish and it will close the media creation tool. And then you'll have the ISO file wherever you saved it on the computer. For me, it was the desktop. So I'm just going to select it and then drag and drop it into this part of the upgrade assistant window here by Flyby11. And when I do that, it'll mount the ISO file. Then it's going to run the setup on that ISO file to bypass the hardware requirements. And as we can see here, the Windows 11 installation can now proceed. Please follow the on-screen instructions in the setup window. So you can ignore the fact that it says install Windows Server. It'll just upgrade whichever edition of Windows you currently have. If I go and have a look at the system settings of this computer, this is Windows 10 Pro. So this will be upgraded to Windows 11 Pro. So to continue, I usually change how setup downloads Windows updates and then click on not right now. And I also uncheck this box to help make the installation better. Then you can just click on next. It's going to do some checks on the computer. And this is usually where it checks if your PC meets the Windows 11 hardware requirements. But because we're using the Flyby11 upgrading assistant that uses the Windows Server setup method, it just skips past those checks. And then you can accept the terms. And here comes the moment of truth, the screen that determines if you can actually keep everything or not. Then next, you can choose what you want to keep. And this is the important part, which I mentioned earlier, why we were using the media creation tool to download the ISO file, because that ensured that the ISO file that we downloaded from Microsoft has the exact same settings as the computer that we want to upgrade to Windows 11. If the ISO file doesn't have the exact same language and region settings as the PC that you're trying to upgrade, then you probably won't see this option here and you'll only be able to keep your personal files, or you'll even be able to keep nothing. But if you want to keep everything, all your files, settings and apps exactly like it is on Windows 10, then this is the option that you want to use. And you can click on next. It's going to do some final checks. And once that's done, you'll see a summary of what is about to happen. And if you're ready to install, you can just click on install. And that is going to start the Windows 10 to Windows 11 upgrade process. Now, once the installation completes, you'll boot directly into Windows 11 with all of your files, settings, and apps exactly as you had them before on Windows 10. Now, the first thing that you'll want to do now is check for Windows updates to ensure that you have the latest security patches and drivers installed for optimal performance. If for some reason the updates aren't working, just pause the updates for 7 days, and then immediately after that you can resume them again and then check for updates again, and then everything should be working perfectly fine. Now, coming back to that third point of being stuck in a loop of failed upgrade attempts, this usually happens due to incompatible software, drivers, failing hardware, or just some sort of file or system corruption in the previous Windows installation. And I have very rarely managed to get a computer to upgrade successfully if I've encountered these issues. My honest recommendation would be to either select the keep nothing option during the upgrade process, or just do a complete clean install of Windows 11 then. If the hardware checks in Flyby11 passed and your upgrade probability was very high, the chances of the clean install of Windows 11 succeeding will also be very high. You'll just need to remember to copy all of your important files to another drive first, so you have a backup of them. And since you'll be starting from scratch, you will need to install all of your software again. But at least this way, you will be running Windows 11 if you want to. But hopefully this video was helpful in getting you to upgrade to Windows 11. And if it was, please give the video a like and consider subscribing to the channel so I know that you want more of this type of content. And now that you have Windows 11 running on your computer, if you want to optimize it, or you just want to uninstall some of the apps that Microsoft doesn't let you uninstall through the native UI, you can check out my video on Winhance, which is a software that I created to enhance your Windows experience. And as always, I just want to give a special shout out to all of my YouTube members. Thanks so much for your support. I really appreciate it. And I'll talk to all of you guys soon.